Yeah, Smart War Games here. Let's check out Panzer and MBT. Two quite sophisticated board games of combined arms, tactical level, turn based. Yeah, and this time no playthrough. We'll talk a bit about it, did some research. And yeah, there's two ways to play this game, a pretty basic way and a very advanced way, or depending on your preferences, you can decide on your own what systems to implement. And yeah, it's not a true solitaire game. Normally I only interested or only focused on solitaire games in this board game week or in general. But it seems like, especially with the advanced rules, you can play it quite good solitaire and the World War II version Panzer even received an expansion for the French War, or for the early invasion of France in World War II, which comes with with dedicated rules for solitaire play. Yeah, you see the sequence of play here on the right. It is not too complicated. MBT is focusing on the Cold War period, as they received some expansions expanding the OOBs or the TOEs with NATO forces and Canadians. Same for Panzers. Both games are quite popular. And yeah, now you might ask, okay, because I usually don't stream board games just for the sake of board games, why I sometimes look for or keep an eye out for board games is as they might offer features that simply most computer war games don't bring to the table. And we had, for example, a couple of days ago, we had Fields of Fire, which offered quite a sophisticated command, control, and communications modeling, which is simply not to be found in most games. And yeah, same here perhaps. If we talk about Cold War, there is a ton of Cold War combined arms games out there. But if you really look for the authentic, for the in-depth experience, it gets difficult. I think there's one game perhaps that is hitting the right nail, and curious, nobody knows almost about it. It's called Flashpoint Campaigns. It is a game of invasion of Germany by Soviet force or Warsaw Pact forces. And it really simulates a lot of aspects that other games never touch or just touch barely, like controlling a force in an ongoing battle with limited command capability. Yeah, you play often games like Combat Mission, where you can simply hive mind all your forces on the map after maximum 60 seconds. That is, of course, absolutely not true to the reality. And yeah, this game, I checked it a bit. The basic rules is nothing special. It won't be different from any average war game or other board games. And that's also why I don't want to do a playthrough of this game, because I looked on YouTube, most people played basic rules. I know why they do that. That's a good thing if you're a new player. You don't want to get overwhelmed, and it's simply difficult to apply all rules at the same time. As I will show you, there is quite a simulation going on here. But still, A, it is redundant, so why do another playthrough? I'm not also interested in playing games on this level. And in order to learn it properly, it would be, of course, see if I want to invest the time and need further input, feedback, and consideration, and if it is worth for me. Yes, and so I won't play basic. I will show you some what you can play basic rules. Basic rules doesn't mean it is some arcade shooter or whatever. There's still some really exciting simulation going on. But if you want to, this game shines with advanced rules. To apply those advanced rules, And a lot of stuff also from might be then a bit minimized, you know, as I often say that turn-based games struggle often because they are turn-based. For example, think Vigo system is one of the most authentic representations of real, especially modern, yeah, real warfare. So as for example, Flashpoint Campaigns is a Vigo game. Both execute orders and orders execute at real time. Not like I move my tank and shoot at you, then you might do something. It is in this game still turn-based, but there's some rules applied like limited commands, formation initiative is a bit changed, and perhaps there are also some house rules to improve that. I think a lot of turn-based games really struggle in this regard compared to the reality. And don't listen what people tell you. Most of those guys never spent a single day on a near a military environment. And even if they did, there's also a lot of people that talk a lot simply because hitting military service is not equaling having a clue. Yeah, absolutely not. Perhaps even the opposite. It is difficult, yeah. Whatever. But turn-based comes with some limitations, no doubt. Yeah. It was designed from its board game roots, origins, as people, of course, can't play at the same time on a board game. It was quite difficult. That's also why we ended up with this introduction of those faces. Everybody knows from ASL and similar games. But yeah, this tries, yeah, also with the basic rules, it looks quite, if you look here, the initiative is simply rolled. Yeah, there's some force grade modifiers applied. That's it. It's of course brother. And if you then have your Abrams tanks or whatever, you can move up and simply blow everybody up. Can shoot all your tanks. Yeah, as you you can execute your fire phase completely before the enemy can react. As you see, first player, second player. That is, of course, sometimes coming with issues. Yes, this game comes with a lot of documentation as a playbook, offering some scenarios. I couldn't see anything about campaigns or whatever. But at least it is a game that comes with some sort of... if you look in the rules book, that is, for example, also a lot of war games struggle with that. Is some sort of organization, Private Schultz or whatever, approaching you. But you have platoon organization, company organization, and can also command, is might be tied, there might be a command radius to this. Yeah, as I mentioned, there's basic rules, advanced rules. Same applies for the World War II game. Yeah. Don't have it now open, but doesn't matter. Yeah, we can set up here, what is it? Four M60s versus four T-72 AVs. Yeah, I mean, Leopard 2 is a bit unfair. Simply set up some vehicles, or let's set up a Leo here. How is maneuvering working? You have a number typically here, 8. Yeah, that means 8 tracked vehicles tracked. Some modifications applied by terrain. You can also look up in those charts here. Here, modifications, 8 modifications. And get bogged or whatever in those trains. Drive there. It's definitely coming with a lot of charts, but that is basically it. If you're looking for detailed in-depth games, we already had this with for example, the game here, Target for Today. You need to look it up. Yeah. Perhaps with time you memorize a lot of it, and then it might be easier. Yeah, let's see, what do I have here for the Soviets? The best tank they have, a T-80U. Let's assume, but that is of course the range would be close. And it's not only about tanks, it is combined arms. Not entirely sure how good this. I know 80 GMs are simulated. And we have some heavy weapons. Command, yeah, okay, that is a bit similar to ASL. Not really too detailed. Of squads, yeah, but okay. It is working, it is not unauthentic or something, it is PM 80 GM sections. What about heavy weapons sections? Okay, AGS section I have. Hand pad, great. Perhaps that is equipment you apply to a squad or to half squad by a heavy machine. Like in many of the leader games. Yeah, that is basically. Seems like to be. Similar. Okay. Pick that T80, let's rotate it. And you can also rotate the turret. Like in other games, everything is encountered, incorporated. And if you would now command combat, which is, let's say that will be our forces, which is of course a completely crazy situation that two tanks would meet each other at this range. That is basically kill range, who fires first kills. As ammunition is simulated quite. Not too random, I think it is simulated quite good. But now roll. D100 or 2D10s. For me 15. And for the Soviets 27, so. Yeah, it depends, I didn't check the. You need to do it in a rule book. If you would design that, you have here numbers. But it seems like they are quite good. Yeah. S-Force we would be in this example veterans, but this tank company is also seasoned. Their company points or command points. That's what I mean, there is then later on you can't give orders to everybody on the map. But you need to watch. I like those games. I like those games that focus rather on this size or significant decisions rather than giving orders everywhere, yeah. Fine-tune every unit every 60 seconds. That is, for example, also check out Flashpoint campaigns. There's a new game coming up, Southern Storm. Really hope that this will end up good. As those guys, we have some nice ideas. This game definitely has issues, no question. Otherwise, I would play it way more. It has some serious issues, but those guys are aware about them. Yeah, and let's say exactly movement. Yeah, there's Overwatch. Yeah, move, fire, short halt, fire, because in Modern Warfare there is also. There is not only halt and fire, but you can also use a short halt, spend some of your points, fire, and then continue movement by perhaps paying a little penalty. Here in this case, you might do a short halt and fire. Overwatch is here, like in other games, if somebody runs into your LOS, you can fire on them. And artillery and whatever. Everything, all the basic stuff. Yeah, let's check now the charts. I think those charts are quite interesting. Now. I really like those charts here as I show you the detail that. There is one tank. That's for example the NATO tanks, but only the US tanks. I mentioned there's British, German, Canadians. We for example now need the Germans. I have a Leo 2 IA4 here. Yeah, what ammo are those guys carrying and rather authentic. The descriptions of it, not AP only or whatever. And here, for example, we now checking the range, that how many tiles we are away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 something. This game considers 5-point blank. It's absolutely fine. MBT firing at this range is absolutely a joke. Yeah, point blank. I mean, some of those maps look rather small, to be honest, for modern combat. I don't know what 1 hex is, but perhaps 1 hex is 100 meters, then it would be fine to some extent. 40 meters would be also fine, I don't know. But that is only a training scenario. You can also link up those maps together, and indeed those later expansions added some big huge maps. And you can also in this module add maps together to a map and then perhaps even fight long range battles. As you see this game, interesting here this. For example here the kinetic round. Okay, here it would be point blank. And the power of the cannon is 120. Yeah, that is, we don't need to calculate. But let's say, and you check 120 penetration power on a T80U. That would be a frontal hit. Turn the turret, of course. And here's the defense information. Yeah, look at this. That is even. He would have ceramic. Now, if these are some improvements, then he might even withstand at least once or something. Is this ERA ammo? Here's ERA. But 110. Yeah, that is impressive. Turret 40. Ah, okay, wait. Turret rear. Turret front. Turret front 110. Turret rear 40. Whole front, whole rear. Now look at this front side. Might even. Me, but oh, 20 or T. Okay, so that might be indeed a bigger range than I was thinking. Yeah, I guess these are millimeters. I'm just a bit impressed that this T80 might survive this round. I don't. If you give a 120 from this distance APF SDS round, it's every tank, at least T80 will stop existing and to the moon, I guess. Heat round, sure, 100 millimeters, and yeah, it is always the same as the heat round is relying on the Munro effect. 120 millimeters, I guess it is millimeters, RHA or something. Homogeneous. I don't know, not an expert on tank combat. But I could imagine that this are millimeters. So you could argue, yeah, you could argue. I think there's a role involved for the hit effect. Okay, and yeah, you maneuver around. Yeah, with maneuvering, you would do something. If you wouldn't fight, you move them around. That is 1, 2, 3. I think while maneuvering, you can 4 move like this. If you want to move like this, you need to pivot and pay one further turn. You can pay movement points and whatever. And command units individually, or at least activate stacks individually. You could have four tanks of Leos in one tile. You also don't need to use those little models. You can also use, like in the classic game, it looks like this. They are better, you can stack them better. Or can you here improve on. Okay. And yeah, about the advanced rules. What is the advanced rules? I want to see that. At least the manual. I won't go through all of this, but let's pick some interesting aspect. And yeah, you can use some modular, pick specific elements and introduce them. There's simulation of air power, nothing some really special. There's also a lot of video games that do that. I will really focus on stuff that is also not that often found in other games. Yeah, definitely this command phase. I talked about this. Command steps. Available commands. Yeah, command might be limited depending on the condition of your force. It might also get worse. Same for initiative. Initiative might change because it is also tied to other elements. Not simply a roll and then simply take. As I mentioned, turn-based games often is rather luck. Ah, okay, now the entire enemy army on the Western Front has initiative. They roll the dice. But might be tied to more detailed aspects and conditions. Yeah, ammo. Some, especially for World War, for Cold War, ammo types. Land fires. Yeah, sophisticated armor. Explosive reactive armor. Infantry receives also further rules like close assault or whatever you know from games like ASL. It's just basically also integrated here. But while the vehicle combat might be more sophisticated. Especially when it comes. I didn't use those rules, but. And it was also hard to see somebody using them, as I mentioned. So no footage where somebody was playing this game really with all rules in play. At least not on YouTube. Looked also for some written information. If you played this game with the full rule set, let me know how does it compare to the best, I mean there's not that many, best computer war games, not many. Ups, Frontilla has some nice modern, some nice Cold War and World War II games as well, of course. Flashpoint campaigns. Yeah, but those games also rather do not. Frontilla doesn't do much with command control. Almost nothing. It's really only Flashpoint campaigns. As we pays tribute to the to this challenge. Then we need two pages and that. Okay, yeah, in the World War II version it looks similar, and if you played the one, you might understand the other game. We can check out the sequence of play, it should be similar. Yeah, looks very similar, perhaps with some minor adjustments and tanks. Yeah, as I mentioned, together with all expansions you have German tanks, yeah, everything what you need here. You want a King Tiger as standard. Or you want... modify those things if information to declutter them. Yeah, Soviets, Americans, British, French. Yeah, that's interesting. French often not depicted in video games. And the Char. Renault tanks. Hotchkiss tanks. And that is from the newest expansion, which also adds, as I mentioned, adds dedicated solitaire rules. I mean, I heard from others that this game is pretty good with solitaire rules, with playing solo, because if you play with the advanced rules, you might define an objective for the enemy force. Sure, you know where they are and everything, but that is basically board game. That is always the problem of board games, that is simply hard to hide units to play proper with Fog of War. It's a big advantage of video games, video war games. But there is something that you don't know what they will execute and how much initiative they will get. And as with those cards and whatever, so you can basically, even if you play against yourself, some elements that will happen in advanced play will make it so surprising that it is like playing against an AI. Just need, of course, some basic rules, like where are they going and whatever. But there's even, you know, we played some games recently with dedicated solitaire rules, which were initially not designed to be played solitaire, like Down in Flames or this tank duel game, and there was another one as well. And it worked out quite good, and same for Panzer, and I also heard that this might be planned or semi-compatible with MBT. And perhaps they will also design scenarios with need dedicated scenarios to play solitaire mode. But this is explained here. With the full rule set you can play in the solitaire mode, and it will explain you how to use and what this units will do. Doesn't seem to be too complicated. Yeah, this is similar to this Down in Flames. You check the AI's unit condition and then apply something. Basically an algorithm that is executed. And that's AI. It is not that much different in video games. The same. The AI has a plan, either from the beginning, or might react to conditions, like you're running in the room, and then the enemy sees you and starts to shoot at you. Basically, in written format here. But so that you know, because otherwise I wouldn't stream this game if it would be not offering some solitaire capability, because I'm not into those multiplayer board games. Yes, and here, if let's say you resolve combat between a tiger and the American Pershing, I mean, both would blow up each other. Both would blow up. Because at the end of World War II, weapon technology was having the advantage over armor technology. Just this, I mean, really close range. What is the map offering? Some long range engagement to test. Let's say this is a hill, right? Let's say I'm parking a King Tiger on a hill. Private CCW, yeah, perfect. Pershing comes. I ambush the Stony. I mean, would be also a move which applies us some negatives to firing. You see behind him, he has this dust, which indicates he's moving. Normally, you would for counters, you would use a moved marker. Yeah. You can also remove it. Spot. This is a bit graphical. If a unit fires, you might also get spotted. Similar to this tank game played yesterday. If you move or fire, you might get spotted. Okay, let's see. Let's calculate. Where's my LOS ruler? How many guys are this? That would be a range of 17. And then you could check this card. I really like those data cards of those tanks. He's even bringing up the right one. How is he doing that? If I select this tire... Oh, that is by accident, right? That would be great if this thing here auto-picks me the... Yeah, that would be, for example, an intelligent... But we have the King Tiger open. Also, that you can't open two of them. Let's see, he's firing. Yeah, we could now assume what is he firing. I would say he's firing APCR. He sees there's some big tank coming. However, APCR might be not that good at angle. Let's see how this game is treating APCR. Doesn't caring. What did we say? How much tires is it? 13, what was it? 17. Yeah, that is long range. The 8-8 long barrel kinetic impact would be penetration 33 millimeters. I don't know, is that really millimeters? Not. This is simply a value. I don't know, it makes on me the impression of it 8 millimeters. But let's say 33. Now let's check the Pershing. The Pershing is hit. Yeah, side turret. Side. Don't know if the turret is hit. Needs to be calculated then. It also needs to be calculated if we even hit. Need to go through the firing process. Yeah, but you could do it. It's definitely over the defense a Pershing, which makes sense. Yeah, those huge cannons, guns, yeah, like the 8-8, the Soviet 120. Yeah, those things were simply, when they hit, they hit. Be hard to protect against them. Pershing was a heavy tank, but not overly heavy. Those German crazy projects like this Maus tank and what. Unpractical tanks that Germans designed out of desperation to find something that from impenetrable fortress. Simply a fantasy. But if it would connect, it would definitely make an impression. No question. Yeah, and you know, would need to roll dice, I think a D100 that you use here, or two D10s, basically, to calculate a 1 to 100. Where you also need to apply factors like experience, maneuvering, terrain, weather and everything. So that's what I mean. If you don't like to check charts, might be not for you. Because this stuff rather, you might rather not memorize. Not in perhaps after I play this non-stop, you might memorize them. This is the command range I talked about and available commands. This is, I think, formation based. So it might be an entire company. Either can give one comprehensive command, similar like in ASL or in other games like that, a leader move. A leader move where a squad leader is telling move and everybody moves with him. But if you start to do individual stuff like you move there, you move there, you get on the hill and park that 80 GM there, stuff will become more difficult. Especially for units that have bad C2. And recovering from that will also become more difficult, These units are then fragmented. So, like in reality, if you have a unit that is not too well trained, you might rather keep them together. Instead of what you see in combat mission, that you drive a single tank there and a single Tony there and here, everything in real time, that is, as I mentioned. Or is often thought to. Here is also if how much over penetration. A BU is a brew up. That is when the entire tank is basically a catastrophic hit. Where the normally you say catastrophic. Of course, not every tank is screw up, but my catastrophic. But it's okay, it will definitely make it explode, which is perhaps true because then you have the confirmation that this tank is gone. With those turrets flying around, or simply a big explosion happening. That is a brew up, Often was reported in the Gulf War that tanks brew up left and right. That's why you often found those tanks without turret, because the turret was still somewhere in space. And for infantry, as I mentioned, tank combat, you can't talk about tank combat or armored combat without infantry. So infantry is us, especially in World War II, there's even World War II was an infantry. Even biggest battles like Kursk, where infantry battles, they are depicted as the tank battles. And so you have sophisticated infantry rules, like you know from other similar board games, turn-based, the usual suspects. Perhaps even more, who knows. That I would have need a deeper inside. Mouse maybe can show yourself from different side if they decide to use this thing somewhere in place with good roles like friends who know. But everybody knows that they could even design the Landkreuzer, which was this Death Star tank. It wouldn't have changed anything. Those tanks, What are you supposed to do with them? I mean, they have no mobility, they're eating up resource you don't have. Sooner or later they might break down and then you're sitting ducks in your tank. That's also what happened. Most of those King Tiger tanks, for example in Kursk, most Tiger and Panther tanks didn't were not lost to enemy influence, to enemy fire, they were lost to breakdowns. And later those King Tigers, I think, most of them were lost to breakdowns. The crews abandoned them because they were out of fuel, the engine didn't work. They were in the middle of the night somewhere and started to get afraid because in the night you see nothing. That is absolutely, I don't know what they were up to. It is absolutely a joke, yeah. Those super heavy tanks those Germans designed, they posed absolutely no operational, no strategic value. And never would have done. Even if they would have designed a Landkreuzer and parked it right in front of the Berlin, they would have simply airbombed the heck out of the Sphinx, yeah. That's not how a tank works. That's also why after World War II, the heavy tank concept disappeared and everybody sticked with this medium heavy tank or heavy medium tank, or which then resolved in this MBT concept. So even a Landkreuzer, look up Landkreuzer, that was some concept art of the Germans. I still wait for a game that finally gives me the Landkreuzer. If you have contact to the STA mod guys, please, I want a Landkreuzer. That is a tank, I don't know, big as a building, I don't know what they were planning with it. Perhaps indeed building a Death Star. Crazy enough they were. Yeah, okay, that was Panzer and MBT. And yeah, about scenario design. For World War II, I don't have now the rule book open, but if, for example here, I think it is included. How is a scenario designed usually? Because you only see a map and think, okay, and now. You take a scenario here, for example, from the expansion book. Everything is written down, conditions, special rules, length, victory points, area, yeah, deployment, zones, special, yeah, we already mentioned that, elements, ah, that is a platoon, okay, one thing is a platoon, picking a platoon or what, yeah, is it a light panzer company, mixed versus a light armored company of the French. Tank only engagement. Yeah, why not? Very unique. You will use some of those Panzer IIs, Panzer IIIs, early ones. And even a Panzer IVD, early versions. And then you start. Yeah, you have the deployment zones. And as I mentioned, there's nothing else. You have victory points. And normally it is a multiplayer game. Then both would play against each other. This, of course, all rules applied. But this expansion here so allows for solitaire play. So if you're thinking about buying an expansion and want perhaps to ramp up the quality of solitaire gameplay, you might want to look for this France expansion. Yeah, that concludes it. See you in the next episode. Good hunting.